Coming with iOS 18.2, you'll be able to generate images using Apple Intelligence and make horrifying avatars. In this video, I'm going to go over all the image generation tools in Apple Intelligence, including Image Playgrounds, Genmoji in Messages, and the Magic Wand tool, which will generate images from your notes and other text, or you can describe an image and it will generate it for you. But it won't make any image you want. I'll go over that in a second. First, let's talk about Image Playgrounds. When you update to iOS 18.2, which it's just the dev beta out right now, you'll be able to generate terrifying images like this one right on your iPhone. There will likely be a waiting list even when the public version releases, but now you can choose images from people in your photo library or yourself and generate these kind of illustration style or animated style avatars. For instance, I can hit the plus button down here, and now I can choose an image of myself or tap the people icon at the bottom and choose people from my photo library. You can also choose a different image for yourself or any of your friends and family members by tapping their face here, then tap edit underneath that, and photos will actually pull images of the same person, and you can choose that to be the new basis of the images that are generated. You can also tap the plus button here if you want to change the animation style, maybe go to that illustration style instead of animation. You can choose other images down here, or you can take a photo. Now, if you try to choose a photo, it's not really going to let you choose photos of objects or things. It really just wants to do people's faces, and it's also not going to do full body imagery. I'll get to that in a second. I'll go back to an image of me, and then you can actually show suggestions for how it can alter this image. Maybe you want to see yourself in a fantasy environment, and maybe change it to Starry Night. You'll see it's adding different elements to the image, generating it here on the spot. Your device gets extremely hot, by the way, and then you can scroll through for different variations of the same image. That's pretty scary. Now, you can also try to describe a change to the image using this box here, but it's going to be pretty limited. I really wanted to generate a picture of myself riding a polar bear, and even if I try to request a full body image using that text, it actually refuses to do anything but basically shoulders up. I guess I might be riding a polar bear, although that bear looks very small. And even if I scroll through, oh my goodness, anyway. But you're not going to get anything more when it comes to the body of just the shoulders. Now, you can save any of these horrifying creations by tapping the three dots and then saving the image, or if you just tap done up here, it's actually going to save it to your library. And then here in your library, you can go back and see all the wonderful images you generated from your friends, family, and anyone else. That's my friend Nate there. I got close to him riding a Pokemon? I don't know. So that's Image Playgrounds, which is really kind of an AI avatar creation tool. That's been the closest to a polar bear I got. But actually, I find a more useful image generation tool is actually the new Magic Wand tool. For that, I'm going to go over to my iPad. So right now in the developer beta of iOS 18.2, this basically just works in Apple Notes. But here, while you're writing, you can take your Apple Pencil if you're on an iPad and just start circling, and that's actually the Magic Wand tool, and it's going to generate an image based on whatever text you have written here in the note. You see, it actually pulled from several different pieces of text. I can remove some of those suggestions and just try to generate something like based on podcast microphones. Then I can swipe through, and I can see different styles of images. If I hit done, this image will actually be inserted into the note. I can resize it, copy and paste it, or I can actually choose this symbol here if I wanted to regenerate and hopefully look a little different. But what's powerful about the image generation here in Notes, and I believe this will be coming to Pages, Numbers, and Keynote in the future, you can actually add some text here to actually adjust the image how you'd like. I can say something like microphone on table. I'll send that command, and now it's going to try and generate it a little differently. Now, it's very much in this kind of comic book style, so I'm going to try and request a photorealistic image. Might have gotten a little better, but it's still kind of that illustrative style. It's not going to get close to the real-life photographic style imagery that you would, like ChatGPT image generation or Midjourney. Interesting side note though, now that we have ChatGPT integration with iOS 18.2, you can ask something like, generate a photorealistic image using ChatGPT of someone sitting at a table podcasting. And you'll see working with ChatGPT now at the top, and you can get an image just like that and save it to your iPhone. And now you can see I actually have a photorealistic image generated and I can save it. Keep in mind you do have to say that using ChatGPT, otherwise, generate a photorealistic image of someone podcasting at a table. And then it will just do an image search like it normally does, and these are not AI generated. It just searched the internet for images like that. Using ChatGPT, generate an image of a medieval knight riding a polar bear into battle. And now we have our knight riding a polar bear. Scroll down and you'll see that it's generated with ChatGPT here. And at the very top right corner, you can choose to save that image to your photo library. And maybe that needs to be my new wallpaper. Now, whenever you use the Magic Wand tool, and you can do it several times in the same note, it's still going to be pulling from random text in the note, and you don't always have control over that. So what I find is an even better technique is if you have some text here. Maybe you're writing a paper on the ancient wonders of the world, and you want an image of the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Well, when you select text, you'll see the contextual menu pop up, and if you scroll to the right, you'll see Create Image is an option. And when you create an image with text selected, now it will generate an image just based on that text. You can scroll through, but I can insert this into my report or my document, and I could see this being useful especially in things like keynote slides if you just want some kind of imagery. You can just generate it here from the text you have. Now, when you generate images using Magic Wand, you can tap the three dots, you can cut, copy, and paste, duplicate the image, remove the background even, and that's kind of interesting. It'll create a PNG file. Again, mileage may vary depending on the kind of image it is. And you can also choose to recreate if you just wanted to generate again. But I was curious what resolution the images were that were being generated, so I created a quick shortcut where if I copy it to my clipboard, I can go over to the Shortcuts app. Here's a simple two-step shortcut where it gets images from my clipboard and it gets the width of the image. And if I run this shortcut, you'll see that's about 510 pixels wide. But if I drag the image to be even larger, I notice that the quality stayed pretty good. So now if I go to the three dots, hit copy, I'll go back over to my shortcut and run it. Now it actually shows the images over 1100 pixels wide. So you do get decent quality images here. It is going to start looking pixelated if you blow it up really big, but pretty decent. Now, one of the big limitations with this image generation is it just will not generate people. Image Playgrounds will do it based on photos you have, but if you try to create an image from something like this, like two people recording a podcast sitting at a table, more often if you try to request something with a person, it'll just give you this error message saying that images involving people are not supported. So if you're trying to get cartoony images of people, it's not going to happen here with the Magic Wand tool. Now, ironically, if you go back to Image Playgrounds, you can choose an image of any person that you save online. So I'll choose a photo I recently saved to my iPad here, and it'll let you just generate avatars of anybody you save in your library. Apparently, it will even de-age them, but it won't create images of people using the Magic Wand tool. So that's Image Playgrounds and Magic Wand, but let's go over to Messages, because the last piece of image generation is Genmoji. Now here in Messages, if you tap the plus icon, you can actually access your Image Playground and generate images right here, or even go to your library and choose one of these avatars you generated. But in order to access Genmoji, you actually have to go to the Emoji Picker, and then here you'll see this little symbol. That's actually Genmoji, where you can create your own emojis. You'll see here you can personalize it, express yourself, and now you can just type in a prompt and generate your own Genmoji. I can ask it to generate an image of a polar bear wearing a medieval knight outfit, and now these are Genmoji that I can attach to a message, and I can also save it as a sticker. So if I hit the three dots, I can save it to my stickers here, even add a caption, or I can add it to the group chat by tapping add, and then send that as a message. Now if I go back to my emoji keyboard, you'll see here in my stickers that that polar bear knight outfit is there, and I can tap and drag that onto a message and attach it like stickers normally do, or I can go in and generate another Genmoji. Now if you ask for anything related to a person, it's going to ask you to actually choose a person here, but I'm not going to do that. Let's do one more, hippopotamus riding a surfboard in Hawaii. And there's your hippo riding a surfboard and a little palm tree next to him. Now, it doesn't have to be animals and places. You can create something different, like ice cream cone with 8 ice cream scoops. You can also generate just random images like that, although that's not 8 scoops. The most beautiful waterfall you've ever seen. But you can even do emojis like this of places, things, just anything but people, basically. So that's Image Playgrounds, Magic Wand Tool, and Genmoji. Do you see a resemblance? Anyway, I imagine Magic Wand is going to be coming to things like Pages, Keynote, and Numbers closer to launch, so get subscribed to the channel and hit that like button, because I'll be covering all the use cases in those apps, and if it's available in third-party applications. If you have any questions, leave comments below this video. And if you want to see more about visual intelligence or other Apple intelligence features, check out this video right up here. Or if you're looking for new accessories for your iPhone 16, I have several of my favorites, including a 4-in-1 Qi 2 charger to just charge all the things at the same time, plus a vacuum sealing MagSafe mount. Anyway, just check out this video right up here. I show it all there. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.